of all the people who really had good years in WWE this year, Matt Riddle doesn't get the credit he should, because 2022 really seemed like the breakout year for the original bro. Matt's year started off as one half of the Raw Tag Team Champions with Randy Orton, the duo known as RK-Bro. The two had been champions since SummerSlam the prior August. They had been on a roll as champions. They would retain the belts at the Day One pay-per-view against the Street Profits. Matt would also do one match on NXT as him and MSK defeated Imperium at New Year's Evil. RK-Bro would get into a feud with the Alpha Academy, Chad Gable and Otis. The duo would lose their tag team titles to them on the January 10th episode of Raw. While still feuding against the Alpha Academy, Riddle also set his sights on singles gold as he would enter the Royal Rumble match, making the final four of it before being eliminated by the winner Brock Lesnar. He also qualified for the Elimination Chamber match for the WWE Championship, also being eliminated by the winner Brock Lesnar. In the interim before their rematch, RK-Bro and the Alpha Academy took part in an academic challenge. Those lasted some many weeks. The Street Profits also got involved in this tag feud on the March 7th episode of Raw in a fantastic triple threat tag. RK-Bro recaptured the Raw tag team titles. A rematch with these three teams was set for WrestleMania 38. That took part on night 2, with RK-Bro retaining their belts. Post-WrestleMania, RK-Bro had a giant bullseye put on their backs from undisputed world champion Roman Reigns, as Reigns told his cousin the Usos, who were the SmackDown Tag Team Champions, to get the Raw Tag Team titles as well. The unification match was set for WrestleMania Backlash, but that turned into a 6-man tag, with the Bloodline getting the win. May 20th on SmackDown was the big unification tag match between RK-Bro and the Usos, where the Usos got the win to become undisputed tag champions. With Randy Orton out due to a back injury, Riddle was on his own. He continued feuding against the Bloodline, even challenging Reigns for the undisputed championship. That match took place on the June 17th episode of SmackDown, an amazing match between the two, with Roman getting the win to retain the belt. Riddle was not done yet. He wanted one more shot at the Undisputed Championship. He had to qualify for Money in the Bank to do so. After he lost his qualifying match, he won a last chance battle royal to gain the final spot in the match, but he would not win the Money in the Bank as that was won by Austin Theory. Matt Riddle and Seth Rollins began a very personal feud, with Rollins taking cheap shots at real life stuff happening with Matt, specifically the end of his marriage. A match between the two was to take place at SummerSlam, but that was called off due to injury, though Riddle still called out Seth during the show. We got a fight instead. The match between the two would take place at Clash at the Castle, with Rollins getting the win. After more weeks of fighting between the two, the rematch was set for Extreme Rules, Matt Riddle's domain, the Fight Pit. First solo main event for Riddle on pay-per-view, and he got the win in a great fight. Now after that, Riddle would spend the last portion of the year in a bunch of random stuff, but 2022 was the year that proved Matt Riddle is a main player on the main roster. The stuff with RK-Bro was great. His story against the Bloodline was great. His story against Rollins was great, and he had some great matches in there as well. As for 2023, if Randy Orton can come back, you got Matt's main program locked.